We are delighted to welcome you to the afternoon program with our guest today, artist Jehabdulloh Jehsorhoh, whose artworks, The Art of Life of Malay Locals in the Southernmost Provinces of Thailand, The Beautiful Flower Hidden in Pattani, Beauty in Dark Pattani, and Remembering Tak Bai, are part of our current exhibition. Jehabdulloh Jehsorhoh graduated as one of the first batch of students from the Faculty of Fine and Applied Arts, Prince of Songkla University, Pattani campus. He then earned his master's in Thai art from Silpakorn University, Bangkok. He is now a lecturer at the Department of Visual Arts, Faculty of Fine Arts, Prince of Songkla University. He also founded Patani Artspace in Nongjik in Patani province. So for today's program, he will be discussing his artworks in more detail and how his Malay heritage influences his artistic art practice. We are also delighted to welcome our guest moderator this afternoon, Dr. Muhammad Arafat. Dr. Muhammad Arafat is now a lecturer at the Department of Southeast Asian Studies at National University of Singapore, NUS. He is also a social anthropologist whose studies focus on various social issues relating to Southern Thailand, including development, social memory, the politics of ethnicity, and the notion of belonging. Over to you, Dr. Arafat.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Jehabdulloh's artist talk. So I was originally asked by Jehabdulloh to accompany him to KL today to kind of help translate in case the audience has difficulty in understanding what he has to say, and then in the end I got roped into becoming the moderator for this talk. When Azad asked about the possibility of me moderating, I actually stalled for a while, and this is important. That's why I'm saying this, right? Because I know him very well, right? We were close, so I thought I might not be the best person to moderate, right? So after a while, we came up with a plan because this talk should be about what he wants to tell the audience and what the audience wants to know. So I have prepared a series of questions, but the format that I propose we move along with is that he will give his presentation and I will translate with every slide, and then I'll ask one question and then open it for discussion, right, to the floor. And so the idea is that it will be much more of a discussion than a kind of presentation. But also, I'd like to point out that we have two other artists whose works are shown here, and they are right in front here. One is Muhammad Suri Yi and Korn, Korakot Sangnoy, so that some of the questions can also be directed to them, right? So, okay, without further delays, let's have Ajahn Jehabdulloh speak.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everybody. Saya maaf na kecek bahasa Pattani. Bahasa Pattani ni sama dengan Kelantan. Sama. Saya minta tolong Arafat dia mari translate sebab kalau boleh translate bahasa English banyak faham lah. Okay.
So he would like to speak in Pattani Malay dialect, and as he said, it's similar to the Kelantanese Malay dialect, and I will translate so that more people can understand.
Okay. Saya we kleh salai lah. Ini di studio di Pattani Artspace.
So this is his studio at Pattani Artspace.
Saya buat gerak ke di Pattani cara-cara seni lukis di Pattani. Saya buat ada tiga cara. Satu, buat bahasa Siam tham art rai. Dua, how bahasa Siam tham yang rai. Bas tiga, why tham phua arai. Buat gapo, buat bekno, buat untuk gapo.
Right, so to explain to you what his the work that he does in at Pattani Artspace. So these are kind of three guidelines, right? Three guiding questions, right? One is what is he doing? How does he do it, and why is he doing this?
Tiga perkara ni yang paling penting cara-cara saya gerak ke di Pattani. Satu buat gapo? Buat bagi hok dok support dengan di budaya di Thailand. Sebab di Thailand ni ada budaya banyak gamai, ada Cina, ada Siam, ada Buddhis, ada Melayu, gamai lah. Lepas tu saya ni jadi satu rakyat Thailand tapi orang persen sikit lah. Saya nak buat macam mana, nak beritahu kata orang Thailand ni ada orang Melayu, Pattani juga jadi satu orang rakyat Siam.
So, in terms of how he thinks about like what he's doing, so he recognizes that Thailand is a multicultural society, right? So with people of varying ethnicities. So he is as a Malay person, he is showing one aspect of this diversity, because he says so. Thailand comprises of other people of not just ethnic Thais, but also Chinese. Thais themselves, and then Muslims and Buddhists. So he is showing one part of that.
Dua buat bekno, buat bekno. Bahasa Kelate buat bekno. Buat bekno buat mari daripada kalau di segi tubuh saya buat mari pada dalam hati, cara-cara jiwa, cara-cara budaya kita ni. Kalau di segi tepat wilayah area tu buat cara-cara tiga wilayah. Kata nak tahu kata tiga wilayah tu ada gapo. Ada budaya gapo, ada cara-cara duduk ke bekno.
So it's what he feels in his heart, right? Like so he is showing like in the three provinces, he's referring to Pattani, Yala, Naratiwat, right? What will you find there? What traditions, maybe what cultures you will find in that area?
Tiga buat identity. Nah, sebab rakyat Siam di Thailand ni ada banyak identity. Tiga wilayah ni. Lepas tu saya kena buat demo tahu kata identity, banyak identity di Pattani ni, tiga wilayah ni tak ada serupa dengan
the north,
Pak Isan, tak ada serupa dengan center Bangkok, tak serupa. Dan tiga perkara ni yang paling penting hak saya gerak, tiga perkara, tiga wilayah, tiga Pattani, Yala, Naratiwat. Sebab tiga wilayah ni ada masalah banyak tahun dah, ratus-ratus tahun ada masalah. Orang banyak di orang Siam ni dia nampak orang tiga wilayah ni jadi bukan orang Siam. Jadi dia rasa, saya rasa masa saya pergi Bangkok, dia nampak saya ni supaya bukan orang Siam.
So related to the first point, so first two points, right? So another key aspect of his work is about identity. And as he said, so there are many identities in Thailand, and then there is also a kind of like regional identity in the three provinces of Pattani, Yala, Naratiwat that sets them apart from people and cultures in or communities in other regions of Thailand, like in the north, and he said Isan in the northeast, or even in Bangkok. And it's not just from inside, right? People from inside the community in the three provinces who see themselves as different, but people in Bangkok, for example, also see them as being different. And And I think he's also kind of referring to So he's also saying that as a Malay from the three provinces, he feels that when he went to Bangkok, right, there is also a sense that people don't see him as a member of Thai society, right? Even though, you know, he's born and raised in Thailand.
Tiga perkara hak saya gerak jadi Pattani sakut dengan cara-cara art. Sebab saya jadi artis lah. Art, saya rasa art satu, artwork. Dua, artis. Tiga, art space. Sebab tiga perkara ni saya rasa kata penting benar kalau kita nak buat gerak jadi Pattani. Cara-cara budaya, cara-cara duduk ke.
So he says there are three things or three A's, right, that are important to what he does. One is it begins with art, or art, his artwork, of course. And then secondly, the artist himself. And thirdly, the art space that he has founded, right, Pattani Art Space. So these are three A's that are central to his art, or how art can play can contribute to social life.
A yang mula art. Nah, saya art yang mula artwork saya yang first artwork saya buat boleh pada inspiration rakyat tiga wilayah cara makanan pakaian buat. Tapi artwork ni saya boleh itipun ke apa ajaan?
Pengaruh.
Daripada mural painting dalam buat ketik seyam. Sebab saya mula study sekolah tu, cara-cara mengaji tu laksud. Curriculum. Mari pada center Bangkok. Saya kena ngaji cara-cara Thai art. Nah, tapi saya fikir gano tempat teh tak ada cara budaya tempat teh. Saya fikir kena buat macam orang Melayu tanning, cara-cara duduk ke di tanning saya buat. Tapi saya boleh inspiration di mural painting ketik.
So so this is his first series of works, right? And so as he said, so it's, if you see the aesthetics, it's influenced by Thai art or classical Thai art. So the kind of mural paintings that you can find in temples. So he said, in terms of the art education that is received, it's influenced, right, by Thai aesthetics or Thai art. And so from looking at mural paintings in temples, in Buddhist temples, and it led him to think it, like, oh. He needs to do something to also show aspects of Malay cultures and like life in the Pattani region.
Sebab dulu masa 16 tahun dulu, cara-cara mengaji seni lukis di Pattani dia tak ada lagi ya. Ada, kalau ada pun ada art education. Mana kata artis tak ada lagi dulu. Kalau ada seni lukis pun ada macam landscape, ada macam tu, tapi tak ada pure art lah, tak ada ada konsep lah. Ni yang paling mula-mula di Pattani. Tapi artwork ni saya nak buat macam mana, nak we orang petani lah, we rasa dengan seni lukis. Sebab dulu dia kena art ni dalam art for function, bukan art macam ni lah. Paling yang paling mula artwork di Pattani.
So when he began his undergraduate education 16 years ago, there wasn't, until then, up to then, there wasn't a like fine arts program in the three provinces. So they've, at the university, they've had a course of training teachers, right, in art education for a while. And so what he also observed was that there wasn't a notion of contemporary art or modern art, kind of like art for art's sake. in the three provinces. So like it's what he meant by art for function was that so there is some kind of like aesthetic practices that are actually just that are actually part of say functional objects that people have been using in society for a long time, just to add, so kind of like, you know, painting on collet boats, right? So those kind of art. Sorry, Jen, to add, so he felt that he also needed to do this because he wanted people in the three provinces to kind of like develop a taste for art, to understand what art can do or the kind of functions that art can have in society.
Lepas siri ni saya buat art, cara-cara kerja apa? Muka-muka. Muka, dia panggil muka di petani muka. Apa, nelaya. Petani panggil muka. Saya suka dengan perahu kolek sebab perahu kolek ni jadi simbol seni di Pattani. Kalau kelih perahu ni, dia mau tahu lah, kata ni seni Pattani. Saya suka dengan sebab dulu, masa dulu saya masuk sekolah, saya buat kerja pun saya pun cari muka juga lah, cari duit untuk nak ngaji. Lepas tu bapak saya pun buat perahu, kakak pun buat perahu. Dan saya buat artwork ni, saya ada satu hari saya hantar tewah di pada Bangkok, Bangkok Bank Award. Waktu boleh nombor satu hok Thailand. Masa tu balik lu.
So after that series, right? So when he embarked on the second series, so he decided to make artworks about that are about the about fishing, because he fishing, and this is the prau kolek, right, the kolek boat, because he says this is one of the occupations that a lot of people in the area have or do, and the kolek boat is also one of the more prominent kind of like symbols of Patanian culture. And also, so like so he was also saying that when he was studying, he also went out fishing, you know, to earn some money to fund his own education. And to give a bit of background, his father and also his brother are boat makers, right? So it's something that he identifies with quite strongly. And then he sent this artwork for the Bangkok Bank Award, the, you know, kind of like art competition, and he won first prize for this one.
Jadi artwork ni boleh nombor satu. 5 tahun lepas tak ada pihak boleh. Baru saya baru boleh. Sebab kalau tak siapa standard dia, tak boleh. Nombor satu. Lepas tu, boleh nombor satu tu jadi sejarah yang paling samkan. Apa samkan?
Penting.
Yang paling penting. Sebab kalau orang luar wilayah, bukan orang Bangkok, nak boleh prize ni payah. Tambah orang Melayu tanding. Jadi payah, susah sebab tak ada connection. Orang jauh lah, jadi artwork ni boleh tu, saya suka lah sebab dia terima. Dia terima artwork ni, boleh nombor satu. Tapi ada masalah. Sebab nama awak ni, saya tak nama bahasa Siam, Roy Pim Chai Jak Chao Malayu Thong Thin Pattani. Apa dia?
Like traces of Roy Pim Chai. So Roy Pim Chai is like traces, right? Of Roy Pim is like traces, Chai is like heart, you know, so like something that kind of like traces of emotions of the Malays of Pattani, or the Pattani Malays.
Lepas tu, dia call mari saya, kata kena tukar nama, saling nama. Sebab saya tanya dia, kata sebab apa kena tukar? dia kata ada masalah dengan
Kuaman Kong apa?
Selamatan. Saya fikir apa sebab gamai tak ada bedi, tak ada bom, tak ada apa, perahu kolek. Tapi gana boleh takut. Saya fikir dia kata nama kena tukar nama. Suruh bubuh Roy Pim Chai Chak Chau Thai Melayu. Belum tu tak ada Thai. Saya buat Chau Melayu Pattani. Bukan Chau Thai Melayu. Dia suruh bubuh Thai Melayu Pattani.
So to begin with the one that he said last, right? So the name was asked to change, to be changed to traces of like emotions of the Thai Malays of Pattani. Initially, it was traces of emotions of the Pattani Malays, right? So let me translate whatever he said. So one of the things, so it's kind of an historical event, you might say, when he won the first prize. So it was the gold prize, because for 5 years before, for the 5 years before he submitted this work, nobody won the gold prize, because unless they deem that a work meets the standard, then they will give the gold prize. So that was something that I was happy about, and especially because he's not from Bangkok, right? He's not from Bangkok, so he's from Pattani. So you don't have connections within the circle. I think earlier he was also saying that, and also previously those who won usually were those who were trained in Silpakorn University, which he wasn't a student yet at that time. But something that was kind of strange was that he was asked to change the name because of for security or reasons pertaining to security, and he felt that it's just a picture of a boat, right? Like there are no guns, no cannons, and so what's the problem? It was because of the name. So like I said just now, so he had named it like traces of emotions of the Pattani Malays, but he was asked to change it to traces of emotions of the Thai Malays of Pattani.
Itulah yang saya rasa sebab bapa dia suruh saling nama. Sebab saya suka dengan budaya, nak bui orang Siam tahu kata di tiga wilayah ada budaya yang cantik, yang comel, bukan orang jahat. Orang yang paling molek ada. Gana dia fikir macam tu semua. Saya tak suka. Lepas tu,
so he, you know, something that he was unhappy about was his purpose for doing this was to show that in the three provinces there is like beauty, right? There is beauty in the culture of, or the local culture, and there are good people, like good people in the three provinces, not just like bad people or dangerous people.
To saya masa tu saya mula fikir ya, kata kita ni kena jadi nampak sepengah kita ni bukan orang sama dengan Siam. Saya rasa macam ni tak kena lah, sebab kita pun orang juga, sama orang, tak ada pihak tinggi kena, manusia semua, bukan demo orang Siam demo kena tinggi, orang petani orang kena, bukan kena sama.
So that made him realize that the Pattanians are not treated equally, right? Which he was sad. He was saddened by that, because it's like, as a Pattani Malay, you are also a person. You know, if you're Thai, you're also a person. Like, there shouldn't be a kind of hierarchy between, like, if you're Thai, then you're upper, you're higher up. in a kind of hierarchy, and if you're Pattani Malay, you are like lower down. We should all be equals.
Tu saya fikir kata seni lukis ni ada power. Ada power nak bui demo tahu cara-cara hidup kita. Saya mula fikir kata saya kena buat seni, kena buat cara-cara aktiviti di tempat teh di Pattani sebab nak bui demo nampak kata kita orang ada budaya, kita ada orang molek. Nah, lepas tu tapi saya tanya profesor saya lah. Kata tukar nama ni boleh tak? Dia kata boleh sebab tak sah fikir banyak lah, sebab artwork ni dia kuat pada nama lagi. Profesor tu dia orang Siam, orang Bangkok. Dia yang baik lah, dia suka. Dia kata saya jadi anak murid mula-mula orang Melayu Pattani pergi mengaji di Bangkok cara seni lukis. Dia suka lah, dia terima saya. Saya tukarlah nama, lepas tu ada exhibition lah.
So so it also made him realize that art is powerful. Art has this potential to educate people, right? To educate people about or make people aware of society, what they have in society, especially in the south, in the three provinces. So then he asked his professor like whether it's appropriate to change the name of the artwork, and the professor told him that yes, it's fine, because you know the art can speak for itself, you know, people can get the message. And his professor was from Bangkok, and he says like a really good person. And in fact, the professor said that he was really happy because he was the first student from the first Malay student from the Pattani region to come to Bangkok and study with him.
Lepas pada siri Prau tu, saya buat siri. Ini nama Beauty in the Dark. Saya boleh inspiration mari pada cara agama, cara duduk ke Muslim lah. Saya sebab kalau kleh artwork saya yang mula sakut dengan cara-cara rakyat, lepas tu cara-cara kerja sendiri, lepas tu ini saya nak berhubung dengan agama sebab cara-cara agama dengan seni lukis ni dia ada limit dia lah, buat macam mana. Saya ambil sebab di tempat teh tiga wilayah ni saya duduk hari-hari, tiap hari tu saya rasa susah hati ya, cara-cara berlaku, ada orang mati. Nah, lepas tu saya ambil sebab pie saya gi Bangkok gimana tu, demo nampak kita ni jadi orang tak molek, jadi orang jahat lah. Saya rasa kata kita nak buat macam mana nak biar nampak orang Muslim Pattani ni bukan orang jahat, ada orang yang molek. Saya ambil simbol hak Muslimah sebab Muslimah ni dia nampak cerak kata oh ni orang Muslim, kalau jatuh ni tak cerak mana. Saya ambil hijab mari buat. Lepas tu kalau Fatih kelih di tengah nampak sepongan batu neser. Sebab saya nak gaya cara-cara kata kita ni duduk di Pattani tu bukan duduk kelih cara-cara duduk ke dunia saja, kena ingat kok mati ya, sebab agama dia suruh ingat kok mati. Kalau kita ingat kok mati tu dia buat bagi kita seni hati ya, kata satu hari kita kena mati, jadi kita tak takut dengan mati ya.
So this is his part of his third series where he began to reflect on religion and it manifests in his artwork. So if you look at his first series, it was about everyday life, and the second one it's related to the kind of work that people do, and third one religion starts to have an influence. And part of the reason why he did that is because like so like he felt that a lot of outsiders, when they look at the Muslims in the three provinces, they tend to think of them as like bad people, right? Dangerous people. So he would like to show that, you know, it doesn't just have to be like that. That, you know, there are other ways to think of them, and so he has in terms of motive, he took the Muslim women, right, with the hijab, because he felt that it's something that clearly is a symbol of the Muslim identity, and it's also about death. So this series is called Beauty in the Dark, right? And so it says, if you look in the middle between the two women there, you will see something that looks like a grave marker that you would find in Muslim cemeteries in this part of the world.
Ani saya pergi exhibition di Abu Dhabi, duduk di situ di residency di situ.
So that was when he went to do a residency in Abu Dhabi. But before that, I also missed out. So he's saying that in Islam, we are encouraged to think about death, you know, and to think of it as just something that is normal, so that you don't fear death. But based on our conversation earlier, I think he also forgot to mention that actually when you think of death, then so when you know that one day your life has to end, you might be more encouraged to do good things rather than bad things, right?
Ning satu siri saya suka dengan artwork ni sebab kalau jadi artis ni, rakyat dia tanya kata art ni boleh tolong rakyat macam mana? Buat art ni untuk sendiri ke untuk apa? Sebab orang petani ni dia tak nampak, dia tak faham lah dengan artis, dengan art ni. Artwork ni boleh bui kantau apa kantau boleh jawab pe untuk rakyat, sebab masa 16 tahun dulu belum nak ada faculty fine art ni di Pattani. Demo tak suka, demo tak sewi ada, demo kata fine art ni tak ada boleh tolong orang Pattani. Kalau nak ada, kena ada bomo, ada wisawak?
Engineer.
Art tak ada guna apa. Saya rasa marah lah sebab demo hina kepada art. Tapi, so akhir ada juga. Tu wak saya kata, nak wak macam mana, nak wik rakyat dia peheh. Kata, art ni ada satu soro nak boleh tolong orang tempat teh.
So this is another series, and he says he's very fond of this one, which is, you know, the one you see there, because he says that he feels that this was a work that could show to the society, especially in the three provinces, that art could benefit society. So backtracking again, so 16 years ago, when the founding of the Fine Arts Faculty was being proposed, a lot of people were against it because they said art has no use in society, you know. So they would prefer like a school of medicine or like engineering, you know. Art is useless, you know. But he's gonna talk about it now.
Artwork ni saya buat masa berlaku di Tabah. Kalau kelih berita di Pattani ni ada berlaku orang petani mati ramai masa tu. Masa tu saya duduk ngaji bachelor lagi di Print of Songkla University di Pattani ya. Saya marah
ajak eh
sebab seksa orang petani mati. Saya buat siri ni, kalau ada dalam exhibition ni ya, saya buat 89 putung batu nesel. Sebab masa tu berita tu banyak banyak berita, tak tahu kata orang mati berapa orang, ada 1 orang, ada 90 orang, ada 70. Tapi saya yang mula-mula tahu berita 89 orang. Saya ambil nak akor tu lah, mari buat batu installation dalam university. Masa saya exhibition sudah tu, saya pergi di Amerika sebulan. Lepas tu klik mari saya tahu kata ketua university dia suruh tahu ambil, kena tahu lah. Sebab dia rasa kata dia tak suka lah dengan awak ni. Sebab dia kata kalau ada ni jadi masalah lah, tak suka lah. Saya marah lah fikir masa tu.
So this artwork commemorates the Takbai incident on October 25th, 2004, right? So there was quite a lot of demonstrators who died in Takbai. So he felt really saddened by the incident because he felt like the state was being what do you call it, like a kind of just being cruel to the common people, right, in Pattani. And so he said he made 89 tombstones or grave markers. So he said that when the news came out, like the numbers, right, the number of casualty wasn't certain. Some said over 100, some said 89. But when he first heard about the news, it was 89. So he made 89 grave markers and installed it at the university. And after the installation, he went to the US for a kind of residency. And when he came back, the artwork was gone. So he said the leader of the university, but actually it's the vice president, so the number one, right, in the Pattani campus of Prince of Songkla University, asked for it to be removed because he felt that it would invite trouble. Or he doesn't like the artwork.
Lepas pada tu, artwork ni jadi popular untuk rakyat di Pattani. Sebab dia rasa, tahu kata artwork ni jadi sorok besar we rakyat. Gambar banyak lah dia mari kecek dengan saya lah buku ni. Dia suka lah dengan artwork ni. Konsep saya nak, kalau clay di bedeh, sebab saya ambil kain putih ni untuk buku mayat. Sebab masa tu ada orang mati ramai nampak, jadi saya tiak lah clay sebab ada orang kenal juga. Saya ambil kain putih mai buku bede, buku bom. Sebab saya rasa kalau tak ada bede, tak ada bom ni, orang tak mati. Sebab bede bom ni buat biar orang bunuh, biar orang mati.
So that artwork actually gained a lot of attention from members of society, and they came to talk to him about it because that's when they realized that artwork can actually give voice to people. And in terms of explaining the concept, like so you see the items that are lying on the ground, that's weapons that are shrouded in white cloth, the kind of white cloth that Muslims in this part of the world use to, you know, to wrap the corpses when before for burial. So he felt that, because he's against firearms, so he felt that, you know, if there are no firearms, like you kill firearms, then, you know, not as many people would die, you know. But because of the existence of firearms or weapons, right, it makes it easier for people to kill one another.
Masa sekarang ni, buku ni tak ada sesal lagi. Orang mati free. Tak tahu kata pia bunuh. Berita kata akad. Apa akad? Akad. Cuaca.
cuaca.
Bunuh orang. Tak tahu kata piyo. Dia kata akad.
So there's still no resolution to this incident, you know. A lot of, so they, you know, in Pattani they say mati free. So it's like you die and like there is no, when it's not natural death and there is no consequence. He felt saddened by it because he also knew some, I mean, aside from this being civilians, he also knew some of the people there, some of the people who died. And so he says, you know, one of the things that has been suggested is that these people died because of the weather, because it was during the fasting months and it was hot, you know, so they died because of the weather.
Lepas tu, A yang kedua, artis. Saya rasa kalau ada art, artis ada. Art ni yang paling penting. Ada art ni, supaya exhibition ni, mari kelih nampak art, tapi tak biasa nampak artis. Apabila tak ada art ni, tak ada nampak artis. Kalau tak ada exhibition ni, saya pun tak mari di sini. Ya. Kena terima kasih Valentine. Ya. Buat bi saya boleh kena orang Malaysia sebab saya rasa orang Malaysia dengan orang Pattani ni jadi adik-wadik. Saya rasa macam tu sebab boleh kecek bahasa Melayu walaupun tak serupa pun tapi ada pehel juga. Jadi saya sukalah mari exhibition di sini ni. Nah alhamdulillah boleh mari.
So the second A is artist, right? So there is no artist without art. Right? So which is why art is the most important thing. So there must be a work, then there's an artist, so then you can see the artist, right? And so but he also wants to talk about the artist because now that you see the art, then you should get to know the artist, right? And so he says he would like to express his gratitude to Valentine for, you know, bringing this show to ILHAM, because then it allows them to also connect with people here, because he feels that people in Pattani and people in Malaysia are like siblings, right? So for one, they can speak Malay, even though it's you know, it's different, it's not the same, but you know, you can understand a little bit at least.
Artis ni banyak daripada faculty di university di Pattani. Ni cara satu gerak di Pattani, seni-seni lukis ni di Pattani ni faculty.
So a lot of the artists whose works are shown here are from the Faculty of Fine Arts, Fine and Applied Arts in Prince of Songkla University in Pattani campus, and this is this picture shows the faculty where he works.
Masa sebab masa dulu faculty cara-cara seni lukis tak ada di Pattani. Saya yang first student boleh ngaji di sini ya. Kena sebab ada guru saya, dia orang Pattani tapi dia orang Buddhis. Dia pergi di Bangkok ngaji di Bangkok di Silpakorn . Lepas tu dia klik mari buka faculty ni. Saya boleh mengaji dia. Kalau saya, dia Buddhis, saya Muslim tapi boleh dia pehe saya pehe dia orang buka faculty ni .
So the man standing there to his left, right? So or right in the picture, one with a bit of a shoulder length hair, that's Achan Pichet, who is the founder of the Prince of the Fine Arts Faculty at the Prince of Songkla University. He's a Thai Buddhist from Pattani. Right, and graduated from Silpakorn, he came back to found this faculty. And he says, so he's also trying to say that, you know, Achan Pichet is Thai Buddhist and he's Malay Muslim, but they can understand each other, they can work with each other, right? Yes, I guess that's it.
The faculty. Ni masa study tu. Saya tiap-tiap minggu saya bawa anak murid pergi painting landscape masuk kampung sebab tujuan saya nak bui orang kampung tahu kenal dengan cara-cara seni. Sebab di tempat ten dia payah, kita nak panggil orang kampung mari kelih art exhibition payah. Kita turun pergi di kampung. Dia nampak kata, oh ada satu kerja, ada satu aktiviti untuk art video peher, derah peher. Sebab kalau kita nanti dia mari, dia tak nampak turun. Pas budak diri pun, anak sekolah diri, dia boleh kenal dengan orang kampung. Boleh kecek dengan orang kampung, cara-cara seni, cara duduk ke. Ini yang yang paling penting saya.
So every week he drives his student around the three provinces to make landscape paintings. And aside from just honing their skills, one of the reasons why he does this is so that the members of Pattani society can also learn about art, can become more familiar or more aware of about art. Because he says, if you just have a gallery or a museum and wait for them to come and enjoy or appreciate art, it will not happen, right? So you have to bring art into the community so that they can see, oh, there is another kind of like occupation or work that people can do, you know, that being the artist. Aside from that, it's also for his students to get to know the society, to get to know these communities, be have a chance to speak to people and understand about their ways of life, right? And hopefully this manifests in their work.
Ini artis di Pattani ya. Sekarang ini 19 tahun. Banyaklah artis baru-baru. Ada dulu kalau dia nak mengaji cara-cara seni lukis ni, ibu bapa tak bui. Sebab ngaji nak kerja apa? Nak make duit mana? Nak boleh duit macam mana? Dia tak sokong. Kalau pergi ngaji bomo, pergi ngaji Oscar, Polik, okey boleh. Ya? Kalau kalau seni lukis dia tak bui. Tapi sekarang ni suka. Keluarga suka suruh ngaji. Sebab jadi satu kerja, jadi satu gerak ke untuk budaya. Jadi sekarang ni okey lah. Jadi keluarga rakyat tempat ten dia suka. Ada banyak keluarga mari cari saya. Goyak kata, ni anak saya ni sekarang ni suka dengan seni. Kalau nak bui dia ngaji boleh ke? Oh, saya mari, boleh. Jadi okey lah, alhamdulillah lah, jadi banyak dia nampak macam ni. Ada anak murid saya susah, banyak saya diri pun susah masa mengaji dulu. Ada kena lekat utai, kena rada tanuh. Tapi ada boyo ngaji seni lukis ni dia boleh. Ada orang collection artwork dia, boleh exhibition, dia boleh duit, boleh gi ambil tanuh rada ibu bapa dia boleh. Jadi dia nampak lah kata ada guna kalau ngaji seni lukis ni.
So this is a picture that shows some artists from Pattani. So he says now there are more and more artists in Pattani, and he says so like in the past you know, parents did not support their children's decision when they want to study art or study fine arts, because like again, like, you know, as opposed to being a doctor, it's even better if you can. Even being a soldier or a police officer is better than being an artist, because, you know, they think that you cannot earn a living from being an artist. But with the kind of development or trends in recent years, things have gotten better. So increasingly, people are more inclined or more receptive to studying art, and there are families who pawn off their land even to take loans to fund their children's education. And actually what has happened, you know, kind of positive development from this is that after they have graduated and they've practiced and collectors come and buy their artworks, now these very same artists are able to buy back the land, parcels of land that were owned by their family. So they start to see the value, at least the economic value of this profession. So So now increasingly parents are coming to see him and, you know, to tell, and they're saying things like, oh, you know, my child is really fond of art. Can he study, you know, can he take up this course? And so he's, he's happy and he's encouraging them to come and enroll at the university.
Yang ketiga, art space. Nah, ini yang paling penting juga. Sebab kalau ada art, ada artis, kena ada art space. Boleh buat aktiviti, video mau pehe. Art space ni saya buat masa 4 tahun dulu. Buat sendiri. Sebab tak ada peer support. Kena buat sebab saya kuasa kita artis di Pattani kalau nak pergi di Bangkok jadi susah. Payah remo nak terima. Kita kena buat sendiri. Kita nak tidur, nak duduk kena ada rumah diri. Nak gi tidur rumah remo payah sikit. Kena duduk rumah diri. Nah, saya buat keluarga saya, ibu bapa saya mai tolong lah. Buat ada anak murid mai tolong buat bangunan ni lah. Buat ni sekarang tak sudah lagi sebab projek ni siapa mati lah. Projek ni tak sudah lagi. Sekarang ni aspek ni jadi satu tempat rakyat petani pergi di sini buat aktiviti banyak lah. Orang yang biasa tak suka dengan art ni jadi suka, jadi sokong. Ada banyak kijau-kijau lah mari di sini buat aktiviti. Jadi satu komuniti. Dia suka. Sebab di Pattani ni kalau duduk dalam bana, dalam kampung, banyak ada Oscar, banyak ada banker. Jadi rakyat dia rasa susah, tak suka hati, tak senih hati. Dia datang di sini, dia rasa suka hati, senih hati. Jadi satu tempat untuk nak buat rakyat ni mari duduk, jumpa, tak ada rasa kata takut. Jumpa dengan pia boleh, mari.
So the third A is art space. So it's again another something that's very important to for artists, right? So he was using the trope of the home. So the art space is like the home for the artist. You know, like you, as a person, you can't just go and sleep in someone else's home, right? So the artist too has to have a home, and that's the art space. So his whole family, you know, they all came together and helped him to build this art space, including his students or former students. So like if you see that picture before this, yeah, so that's them building the art space themselves. That's if you can see, that's him, you know, digging for the foundation, right, of the building. And so he says, if you go to the three provinces, there are a lot of checkpoints, military checkpoints, military kind of like structures around. So he says, like for a lot of locals, they also feel a kind of a sense of discomfort, right? It's and you know, this sense of just being worried about what could happen, you know. But it has become a kind of a space for community. So a lot of people, not just artists, but just a lot of people come to the art space, and it's also a kind of like therapeutic space. They feel happy when they come. So this art space, beyond just being a place for an exhibition of art or for making art, it is also a space where that brings people together.
Saya buat sendiri ya. Sebab masa mengaji dulu susah, tak ada duit nak ngaji. Saya kena kerja. Cari ikan, muka, buat rumah. Sebab nak ambil duit tu mari untuk mengaji. Sebab keluarga susah. Lepas pada saya mengaji tu, saya minta dengan bapak saya, kata saya minta tanah. Kita orang susah tapi muju ada tanah untuk nenek. Saya minta dengan bapak sebab nak buat art space ni. Dia kata kalau ambil tanah ni buat art space, nak makan nasi mana? Sebab di tanah ni tane padi. Untuk keluarga makan, ada nasi makan, tak kena beli lah. Saya kata nanti nak buat padi macam lain. Bukan padi biasa lah, nak buat macam lain. Kalau satu hari kalau boleh rezeki nak bawa bapa pergi di Mekah, insyaallah.
So okay, so after he had finished his master's, right? So when he was when he had this idea of building this art space, he asked his father for land, right? For this land to use this land. So he says he doesn't come from a well-to-do family. So in fact, from a poor family, but they have inherited this land from, you know, the ancestors, and they were planting rice. So this was basically a rice field. And his dad's response was like, if you use this land to build an art space or a gallery, then, you know, what are we gonna eat, right? Because they're eating rice that's harvested from this rice field. Then he's saying, you know, he will make a different kind of rice for his father. So and he told his dad that, you know, one day, like, this art space or this new type of rice field will send you to Mecca to perform the Hajj.
Lepas tu saya buat sini satu tahun, dekat-dekat dengan dua tahun boleh hantar bapa, boleh keluarga, boleh pergi Mekah sebab ada kolektor mari tolong collection artwork saya. Jadi jadi kolektor dia pergi collect artwork di sini, saya rasa dia tu boleh pala. Sebab di sini ni buat untuk masyarakat. Saya buat ni duit sendiri semua. Saya cari duit, ada gaji, saya mari buat ni. Tak ada duit nak taruh untuk keluarga lah, tapi saya mari buat di sini. Saya sekarang ni susah lah, tapi susah macam ada makan lah. Boleh duit, saya turung di sini. Boleh duit, saya turung di sini. Saya rasa orang kolektor mana mari beli di sini, supaya dia boleh pala juga lah. Sebab kita buat tempat training, tempat supaya tempat wakaf lah, di segi agama lah, buat untuk masyarakat lah.
Okay, backtracking a little, I missed something. So the reason why he's able to do this was, you know, he comes from a poor family, and when he was studying, he had to support himself by working, doing all kinds of jobs, including being a construction worker. So about between one, I guess more than 1 year, but less than about 2 years after he had built this Pattani art space, he was able to send his parents to the Hajj with money that he earned from collectors who came and buy his works. And so he's much better off than before. Like, he has food to eat, but, you know, whatever money that he earns from selling the artworks and all that, he puts into building extensions or developing this project further. And, you know, he's using his own money, but, you know, it's really for the community. So like we said before, it's become a kind of a space for community, for people to get together, kind of therapeutic space. And so he says it's similar to this like concept of the waqaf, right? So something that you kind of like give to society, you know, for public benefit. So so he says in a way it's like when collectors buy artwork from them, that like you get merits from these purchases.
Any activity di Pattani Artspace, yeah.
So some pictures of activities and exhibition set.
Di masa Arafat dia datang di Pattani Artspace, saya rasa saya gerak ke ada tiga A, art, artist, art space yang paling penting. Sekarang ni ada A yang keempat, Arafat.
So this was that's actually a picture of me doing this, translating for him, and then that's Sid Perez, who's a curator at NUS Museum. Then that's Hilmi, my younger brother, who's curator at National Gallery Singapore, and Danny, who was a curator at ACM. And so, yeah, he takes opportunities like this to organize talks for his students or anyone who wants to come to listen to hopefully something that's beneficial. But it was just a joke. So he says there's a fourth A, which is Arafat.
Sebab kalau nak ada aktiviti yang bagus di center ni payah lah dia nak datang Pattani dia tak nampak lah. Jadi ya Arafat dia kena ni jadi ada aktiviti banyak lah untuk artis muda-muda di Pattani. Jadi ada boleh ilmu, boleh apa lah.
So as you're saying, it's hard to, because they located quite far away from Bangkok, right? So when they organize activities, it's actually quite difficult to get people from outside the area to participate in their activities. But you know, beyond kind of like talking about what, you know, about me, you know, it's like when we, all of us, right, when we visit, right, we help them establish that kind of connections or that kind of networks that will bring people to Pattani and in a way bridging that distance between Pattani art space with the, you know, with the larger world.
Sekarang ni ada banyak lah rakyat di Pattani mari buat aktiviti di sini ya. Banyak di Pattani ni tiap bulan ada aktiviti cara-cara peace, eh, santipap. Lepas tu ada embassy banyak lah datang di Pattani. Dia pergi Pattani, dia datang di sini. Dia suka, dia nampak, dia sokong lah, nampak dia mari kelih jadi sini ni jadi yang samkan, apa samkan penting, yang penting ada di Pattani nah. Ni budak sekolah tadika, sekolah private school go apa rataban apa kerajaan university mana mari buat aktiviti di sini. Saya suka lah, ramai mari tiap-tiap bulan ada aktiviti di sini.
So now they have a lot of activities, like every month they have something. So like this is these are students from like weekend school, like a weekend madrasah, you know, but also students from primary school, secondary school, high school, universities. Like they have this kind of activities where they make art. And they also get visits from like embassies, and so far the feedback has been positive. Like they like, a lot of people like the fact that members of the community are able to come and participate in what they are doing, right? As a project, what they're doing, and he too is really happy about this.
Sekarang ni ada parti pakan mungkin apa? Parti politik. Politik parti banyak lah datang nak buat aktiviti cari sorok.
So even now there are a lot of political parties who are going to the art space to cari sorok, to kind of like a
hasiang untuk nak pilih ya.
To campaign right, cari sorok is to look for voice right, so yeah, to seek support for, because they are all anticipating that an elections will come at some point.
Aktiviti tiap bulan ada exhibition, ada aktiviti banyak lah. Ni saya rasa sini jadi tempat yang paling penting untuk orang rakyat di Pattani. Saya suka jemput seluruh dunia datang di sini ya. Boleh jumpa, boleh kenal orang Pattani macam mana. Saya rasa gamal lah orang tak kenal lagi kata Pattani macam mana. Kalau tak tahu sejarah, tak. Jadi tak tahu lah, lisuh tak tahu. Sebab kalau sebut Thailand ni, dia mau pergi kata Siam. Pattani duduk di mana? InsyaAllah saya pada pergi jemput pergi di Pattani, saya boleh take care lah.
So yeah, he's happy to play host to anyone, you know, around the world to come to Pattani Artspace and get to know the society, you know, their ways of life, the situation. He says because for a lot of people, if they don't know the history, right, when they think of Thailand, they think of Siam, right? They don't, so, you know, Pattani doesn't exist then because people are not aware, you know? So he's inviting all of you, you know, to come to Pattani, to come to Pattani Artspace and, you know, within his means, you know, he's happy to play host to all of you. Yeah. Okay, that's it. Okay, so I'll just, you know, kind of kickstart the conversation with this question, right? Ajahn Cik Abdullah, you know, you can see that he's speaking in Pattani Malay, but even then, you can sense some difficulties that he's experiencing, and this is actually quite normal, like. For a lot of Pattani Malays, when they come to Malaysia or they come to Singapore, and they even when they meet other Malays, right, and you know, so in a way they think that they are Malays, so they should be able to interact with one another kind of like seamlessly, but it's actually quite tough, you know. Sometimes they experience difficulties. Actually, he would be able to do this presentation much more comfortably in Thai. You know, I often, even myself, I often get people asking me like, oh, you know, what do the people speak there? You know, do they, you know, or people think that they don't speak Thai, you know, because that's what you read, like they reject anything Thai, right? But actually, a lot of them are much, much more comfortable speaking in public in Thai, right? So I thought, you know, I'll just start with asking him to elaborate a little bit more about that.
Hening hak saya sebut dalam hati ni. Orang Taning ni. Jadi sepunga anak tiri. Sebab saya duduk di Pattani, negeri Thailand. Ngaji kena ngaji bahasa Siam. Saya sungguh kata kecek Siam ni mudah pehe pada bahasa Melayu Taning. Tapi mari sini saya kecek, saya rasa kalau saya kecek Siam, walaupun pehem, tapi saya tak ada suka. Saya rasa nak kecek bahasa Pattani. Saya suka dengan bahasa Pattani. Tapi pia mari di Malay, bahasa Malay pun tak cerak. Jadi, nyanyo orang Pattani ni. Nayu pun Nayu tak cerak. Jadi, kena ning orang kata sebab politik ni. Buat we orang-orang jadi susah. Support dengan orang Malay lah. British datang orang Malay nak kecek Melayu. Jadi sekarang ni saya tak tahulah macam mana. Sebab orang Taning sekarang ni banyak kecek Siam. Melayu, Jawi ni jari. Dalebana ni kurang lah banyak kecek Siam. Sebab popular ke sebab apa dah. Tapi saya rasa bahasa ni penting, kena kecek, jangan tinggal, kena kecek. We ada. Sabit saya nak pakai bahasa Taning ni, nak kecek bahasa Taning. Walaupun tak pehe pun, tapi kita pakai hati pehe. Hati bi pehe. Kecek pehe tak pehe tak apa, tapi hati bi pehe. Kalau kecek pehe, hati tak pehe ni, kok tu Masya Allah. Kok tu Masya Allah.
So, he said this is something that you know, kind of saddens him, you know, something that he feels quite deeply about, because as a, so for the Pattani Malays, like, you go through education in Thai, right? And you speak Thai, and actually you're much more fluent or much more familiar in speaking in Thai, but you say you're Malay, and then when you come to Malaysia and you speak, when you try to speak with Malaysians or you try to speak like standard Malay, and you know, it's, they can't do it fluently, you know? So in a way, it's asking like, you know, is there something like a kind of Malay deficiency for themselves, you know? And so it says, it's like, if you're not here, neither are you there, then, you know, where are you, you know? But he says, like, even though, so like I pointed out, even though it would be much easier for him to present today in Thai, but he wants to speak in Pattani Malay because this is what he feels deep inside his heart, you know? So he says, it's fine if he's not fluent or if people can't understand him fully, but you know, he feels that it's something that can express what he feels in his heart. So he says, when, you know, in a way, he's saying that, you know, if he speaks in a language that he fully comprehends, or if the audience fully comprehends, but you can't feel what's inside his heart, he feels that it's better if, even if you don't understand what he's saying, but you can feel his emotion. So that's what he's going for, and that's what made him decide that he wants to speak in Pattani Malay today. So he wants to.
Supong masa sekarang ni ditaning. Saya kecek bahasa sie cerak ah. Kecek dengan orang sie orang kerja kecek cerak, tapi tak peh hati. Pehe bahasa tapi hati tak pehe. Makna kata walaupun kecek cerak tarono kalau hati tak pehe pun. Jadi ada masalah. Ada masalah kita nak gapo tapi demo pehe bahasa kecek tapi hati demo tak pehe. Makna kata manusia ni hati yang paling penting. Kalau ugamo gapo catipan gapo ni? Bangsa gapo kalau ati pehe bahasa manusia ni tak ada masalah. Manusia tak ada masalah kalau ati pehe.
So yeah, he wanted to elaborate, right? So he says that like he's fluent in Thai, right? And in fact he's very fluent in Thai, and so he says, and when he converses with whether it's like bureaucrats, right, in Thai, and they would understand him fully, right? Just the language from a linguistic perspective. But they don't understand, you know, what he feels in his heart, his emotions, how he feels about issues. So actually then you see, you can understand, you know, in terms from a linguistic point of view, but you don't understand how they feel, what they want, what they want to do. Then you will still end up with a big problem, a problem that you see today. He says, but to compare, if somebody, you know, doesn't understand what he's saying fully, from again, you know, in terms of just language, right? But you can understand what he feels in his heart. Doesn't matter, you know, whatever your ethnicity or whatever your religion, right? You know, it is still much better. Like, there probably will be lesser problems. So he says, like, so what he's saying is it's a kind of language, you know, for that emotions is a kind of a language of humanity. So with that, maybe, you know, there are some questions that some of you might want to ask him. No questions? So no? Oh, yes. So two questions.
Thank you. Bagaimana Achan Abdullah boleh akan melihat seni yang cuba disampaikan ini di masa akan datang? The future of art in Pattani, how you see this?
Saya fikir kata seni di Pattani ni masa dak pen ni kena buat untuk masyarakat, untuk rakyat di Pattani. Jaga budaya, jaga bangsa di Pattani. Tapi dak pe lagi kena untuk manusia. Saya planning tu dak cerak lah, tapi budaya bangsa di Pattani yang paling penting kena jaga lah. Jadi satu kerja artis. Sebab saya dak tahu, sebab masa sekarang ni ada berlaku cara-cara berlaku tu jadi inspiration untuk artis kena tolong rakyat Pattani masa sekarang. Tapi kalau masa sekarang, masa dak pe tu, kalau Pattani peace ada dah, boleh ada idea dia saling lah. Sebab Aning dia duduk dak dia ya, dia kena saling sama, duduk di kada air dunia, kada air cara-cara duduk ke manusia. Sepunga di Europe dah masa musuh dulu, ak dia kuat lah. Lepas tu lepas pada musuh, ak dia soft. Ada dia, sepunga kita sepunga ujian turun lah. Hari ni ujian turun, kita kena pakai payung. Esok ujian tak turun, kita tak pakai payung. Duduk di udara, kata nak jadi macam mana. Ak ni dia gerak sokmo. Dia tak duduk dia, dia gerak.
So his response was, because of the political situation in the Pattani region today, so if you see a lot of the artworks trying to give voice to like local opinions, local interpretations of events, so he likens art to a situation where if it's a rainy day, then you will walk out with an umbrella, right? But if you know when the rain stops, then you won't use the umbrella anymore. So it's hard for him to prospect forward, right? What you know, what directions they will take, but definitely, you know, it will. His art is constantly evolving, and so it will evolve with changes in this kind of like social environment that they are in. There was another question here.
Not really a question, but I'm born in Sweden, so I'm a Swedish Malayu. My parents is from Pattani, so for me, when I go to Pattani, it's quite difficult to communicate with the younger generation because they are so influenced by the Thai language. So Bahasa Melayu, bahasa sikit lah. Kita boleh kece sikit. Kita tak boleh kece bahasa Sia, kece bahasa Melayu. And I have another question, that is there a way for the international generation Malayu that lives in Europe, in America, is there a way to find the art, like you have art space, but you have it somewhere that people outside of Asia can see it also?
Jadi demo sepuluh kita rasa duduk sama tengok, ketiak lening dak cerak, lening dak cerak. Rasa sepuan nak diri ya, mudah-mudah. Tapi
nyanyi anak tinggi.
Jadi peh, saya peh. Tapi saya rasa satu hari ya, ah ni boleh lah nak bui international tolong. Saya rasa lah kalau insyaAllah kita kena pakat rakyat kita kena pakat, kena peher lah. Kata ning satu yang gerak ke untuk orang petani kita nak bui, nak bui santipa habis tempat teh kita, you boleh duduk kesene orang tempat teh kita.
Yeah, so I guess his response is like, you know, he doesn't know how that would work, but he believes that if there is a will, you know, there is goodwill, and you know, people willing to get involved and kind of like contribute to spreading awareness of what they do. He feels that art could contribute to peace building, you know, peace building through awareness, right, of how people in, you know, three provinces live their lives, you know, kind of issues that they face and their own, what they think about all these things. So it's kind of like peace building through education or through awareness, through art. Maybe another question?
Boleh tolong lah kalau nak tolong, sebab kita kena pakat orang tani duduk Sweden, tapi kita kena pakat tolong sebab orang kita kena seksa banyak . Jadi cara mengaji pun buat salah . Jadi kena pakat lah, tambah cara hang ngaji ni kena biar ada jangan kelih kat dunia saja. Mudah-mudah kita kena pakat we orang buka dunia, buka we pehe dunia apa patu pakat bangunne cara-cara tani kita ya dia lah.
Yeah, you know, so he's saying that you know, for like especially other Patanians who live in other parts of the world, right, like, you know, you have to kind of maintain these relationships, right, and you know, where you can help one another to kind of like raise standards or just the lives of Patanians. And actually, this is an interesting point. Like my own ancestors were from Patani, right? And I live in Singapore, but there isn't a kind of a Patani consciousness that is very. In fact, a lot of people might not even know that their ancestors were from Patani. My own research is about Patanians in Mecca, right? And the third, fourth generation, a lot of them don't feel that connection to Patani. And in fact, like, you know, you still speak some Patani Malay. A lot of the Meccans, right, the Patani in Mecca, they don't speak in Patani Malay. So like when I do my research, a lot of them feel shy. You know, maybe I'm just not a shy person, so I will speak Patani Malay anyway, even if I make mistakes, but a lot of them feel shy even speaking to me. So so I think he's also trying to kind of highlight this point that, yeah, you know, I mean, it's everyone's choice, but there isn't that kind of Patani consciousness that is clear. Any other questions? Yes.
Saya cuba kecek petani.
Ya.
Kalau tak faham, bagi tahu. Petani, kalau lukisan artnya, kalau budak-budak atau yang pelajar, apa-apa yang pengaruh dia suka lukis itu apa? Pengaruh dari segi abstrak ke atau pemandangan? Satu lagi, kalau pengaruh Islam pun kuat di sana kan? Jadi ada ke macam restriction atau limitation yang ada yang boleh buat, ada yang tak boleh buat?
You want to translate to English? Oh, okay. I'll just do it. So, so yeah. So she's asking, like, you know, what kind of influences, or what, I guess, what inspires these young artists or students, especially, you know, what kind of, you know, what kind of art they'll make, and or what kind of motives are there, constraints, like, oh, you can do this, you cannot do that. I think this is a very good question, especially for him, because you see, you know, he kind of deviates from our conventional understanding of what Islamic art is, right? Yeah.
Ada sebab saya di biasa kena ada orang mari royak kata ni tak boleh. Saya pun cakap dengan dia lah, kata macam mana, sebab kita buat teh bukan buat untuk puja, buat untuk niat untuk nak buat we molek. Sebab saat ni jadi satu, orang panggil kata satu mesej, satu material untuk nak keluar, nak dakwah. Biar orang pehe duduk ke manusia. Bukan kita buat nak puja. Saya fikir, saya kata demo pakai duit. Duit duduk dalam beg demo tu. Nanti nak ambil.
Banyak duit ni.
Duit duduk dalam beg. Upo apa ni? Portrait. Dah. Demo masuk dalam rumah. Buat masuk dalam beg. Demo duk pakar. Kalau lukisan mahare, ni pun hare. Tak boleh bawa masuk rumah. Saya kata, duit demo tu buat kita. Jangan bawa masuk rumah. Buat masuk main-main mai kita. Mana kata duit ni buat untuk beli barang, pakai kijo. Bekir untuk puja. Seni lukis pun macam tu. Tambah masa sekarang ni, manusia mana tak tahu cara-cara agama ni teruk. Oh. Sebab ilmu ni dia luah banyak sekarang ni. Kalau kita kata, oh buat ni tak leh, ni tak leh. Dia kena kelih di niat dia, dia buat untuk apa. Kalau pakai spiyoh, pakai hijab, tapi duk kelih goye, duk buat macam hari ni, tak boleh juga. Mana kata kita ni buat ni duduk di niat, kita niat nak buat apa, nak buat untuk apa ni. Function dia. Kalau itu tak boleh pakai duit. Di Mekah, saya pergi di Mekah. Dalam umuh, gambar raja. Raja Saud tu. Duduk dalam kedah, duduk dalam rumah. Boleh ke macam tu? Kalau dia boleh, kalau kita tak boleh. Macam mana? Duit Saud pun ada agak rupa. Mana kata function dia buat untuk apa? Kalau tak boleh duit ala saya, saya nak pakai. Kalau tak boleh.
So he said that this is something that he's had to deal with, right? You know, people say, like, you know, how can you paint portraits or have you know, these figures of people in your paintings? And so one of the ways he's responded is by, you know, taking out, so he was showing money, right? Like, you know, a lot of currencies have like portraits of people in it, you know, and said, you're using money, you put it in your bag and then you use it to buy things and you go home, you keep it. It's like, why do you keep something that is haram in your home? Why don't you give me all your money? At least I can use it too, you know? So he said, oh, like when he went to Mecca and he saw portraits of the Saudi kings, right, in people's homes or hotels or shops. And even, you know, Saudi riyals has portraits of, you know, of figures or kings and all that. And he says, you know, so why is it that when you are using it, it's okay, but when we are doing it, you know, in the form of art, it's not okay? Why is it okay for you and not for us, you know? So this kind of double standards, right? So he says it starts with, you know, what are your intentions? He says, you're not using this to, you're not praying to these objects, right? You use it, there's a function, and, you know, so the intention, you know, fits the functions, and that's it. You know, so that's how he deals with it. Any other questions? Yes.
But I speak loud enough. I'll speak in Malay first and then I'll. Dalam 20 tahun, 30 tahun sudah ni, kita tengok di Selatan Thai, apa ni ekonomi dan apa keamanan dia bergolak naik turun. Tapi overall, puratanya kita tengok, rata-rata apa ni kedudukan kehidupan orang Melayu kita di Selatan Thai ni, tiga sam camwak ni, dia molek, makin molek kan? Kereta makin besar. Kalau 30 tahun dulu, di Tang Nyumah tu ingat tahun 70 gajah pun ada jalan. Boleh lain tak ada lah. 20 tahun dulu di jalan tu tak ada kereta baru, kereta buruk semua. Lalu ni kereta baru betul tak?
Yeah. Ha.
Jadi masa yang sama ni nak tanya macam mana acceptance penerimaan apa ni kesenian art ni silap art ni di Selatan Thai di kalangan orang-orang Buddha, orang yang tidak Muslim, macam mana dia melihat kita? So in English I was asking him for the past 20-30 years in Southern Thai there has been a sort of stability where the standard of living is much, much better than 30 years ago where, like in our telling him in Tang Yumas, there was even elephants in the streets, you know, like a taxi, like a transporter. But now you see new cars and the economic standing is improved and everything. So I was asking him what is the acceptance among the Muslim, the localities, and also the non-Muslim from the north or from the entire southern region. That was the whole question.
Thank you.
Sekarang ni kalau terima dirasa tu dia suka. Sebab support saya buat Patani Aspeh ni. Saya pakai nama Patani ya. Sebab nak bui kata cara seni lukis ni satu cara-cara sakut dengan dia. Dia mari kelih. Dia suka. Dia nampak kata oh. Ni budaya kita. Dia rasa suka lah. Di segi rasa. Tapi di segi nak support, nak terima beli tu tak lagi lah. Sebab dia kata kalau beli artwork ni, baik beli kereta. Beli buat apa dia? Baik beli kereta. Artwork ni gugi lah kalau beli. Baik beli barang makan kan. Dia tak nampak lagi lah. Tapi banyak dia suka lah dia asing projek kata muncul lah ada seni ni sebab boleh jaga budaya bangsa dia lah. Boleh jaga walaupun orang bukan Muslim pun dia pun suka sebab artis di situ pun bukan orang Muslim Buddhis pun ada sebab dia art ni buat biar orang mari jumpa. Ah ni buat biar orang peha. Orang panggil kata bahasa sia ni silapa song tang hai kek kan. Culuh jale. Culuh jale bui ku manusia. Buke seni ni buat biar orang mari balah. Saya rasa kalau seni ni kalau manusia kata tak boleh tolong manusia. Tapi seni tak biasa bunuh, tak biasa jajah manusia. Yang paling penting. Saya rasa gitu. Baik pada orang kata, yoning ni, nanti goning ni boleh tolong manusia. Tapi, belakang tu, doa ngenak manusia lagi. Baik seni lukis. Sebab kalau dia tak tolong manusia, tapi dia tak biasa jajah manusia.
So he says generally the reception has been positive. Like people come, they appreciate what they do, and they feel that. So he was giving this example of the pa, right? The pa or the Pattani Artspace. You know, it the idea is that he wants to bring art closer to people in Pattani, and so whether Muslims or non-Muslims, generally the reception has been good. But although you know, it's not necessarily. I mean. whether it has reached the stage where people see the artworks and say that, oh, I want to buy this or not. They feel that, so he says they would feel that it's still better to buy a car, for example, because, you know, there's function. So it's not at that level yet. But he says, in terms of art's contribution to, or art makes, or art brings people together to relate to one another. He says, but even if, you know, one can disagree with that. He says, so even if it doesn't bring that kind of benefit, but it's not something that has bring, that has brought about a kind of like negative impact on people. So he says, so what he was saying that art has never hurt someone or a person, nor has it menjajah, like colonize a person, a literal translation. Yeah. So maybe a final question? If not, maybe I'll just ask one final question about art, the art space, right? So I'm going to ask him a question about, like, since he has opened, or since he began this project, right, the Pattani Art Space project, and what has been kind of like the result, maybe, of that has made him that he has been most satisfied with or happy with, right? And I, just a bit of context, I ask that because it's, you know, it's not something that you and I do every day, you know, build something from the ground up, and like it involves a lot of his own like financial investment, energy, his family and all that. So, you know, maybe just kind of one thing that he feels most satisfied with that makes him feel that, you know, all this kind of like investments has been worth it.
Saya suka nampak manusia boleh mari jumpa walaupun agama lain, walaupun bangsa lain boleh mari jumpa. Saya suka manusia jumpa, suka, tak ada marah, tak ada bunuh, tak ada. Saya suka sebab saya kata manusia ni, dunia ni kalau manusia tak marah, tak baloh, ha, dunia ni seni. Tapi holah dunia lah, dunia. Kalau di segi agama ni, dunia ni samutaro. Sabik tu lah gapo-gapo berlaku dalam dunia ni jadi cuba eh. Tapi saya ingat kata saya satu hari pun saya kena mati. Apa yang penting saya duduk atas dunia ni nak buat bi manusia dikasih. Kita mati dah sebab di segi agama ni kita mati Tuhan dia tanya lah kita duduk atas dunia ni kita buat gapo ikut manusia tik yang paling molek bekek Tuhan tanya kata kita ni buat gapo kut sendiri tik dia dak tanya, dia tanya kita buat gapo paling molek kut manusia hak tulah yang paling labo kita masa dak pe ni di segi agama lah, agama Islam lah. Dan saya walaupun agama lain, bangsa lain, tapi saya dia tu manusia juga. Nak macam mana kita kasih tolong, tolongan. Dan saya suka lah, saya nampak banyak mari datang juru Amerika, mari Jepun, China, Taiwan datang mari. Boleh jumpa, boleh suka, boleh kerana. Alhamdulillah, saya suka situ. Walaupun saya letih pun, tapi saya suka.
So, you know, the in terms of what he has been most satisfied or happy with is that since, you know, since Pattani Art Space opened its doors, people of all kinds of backgrounds, right, the ethnicities or religious backgrounds have been able to come together in good spirit, right, in good spirit and just being happy in the presence of one another. And that's what is most important to him, and just from his own religious beliefs as well, that he says one day he has to die, right? We all have to die, and he says that, you know, God will not ask, you know, will not ask him like, what have you done for yourself, but what has he done for humanity, you know? So he feels that this is something that is kind of like the most profitable investment for him. And he says, again, you know, just to give example, people have come from Japan, Taiwan, China, from Europe, from the US, or from the Americas, and and generally they've all enjoyed coming there. And he says, if he can contribute, or if this contributes to just a better world, you know, like people don't come, you know, in anger or, you know, feeling just with like malicious intentions to one another, then this is what makes, he says he's tired, but you know, it kind of like alleviates what he's gone through. And so if there are no other questions, I guess we'll end the session. Thank you for coming and joining us on a Saturday evening.